Hey everybody. So you are depressed, agitated, angry with just life, you know, just agitated and angry or stressed and overwhelmed, frustrated like you could tear things apart, either because your relationships are suffering, your parenting journey is really hard, your career is going down, you're working so many hours, but your job is not giving you the money that you want, scrambling for money at the end of the month, and a ton of other things that we could list down. And you're thinking, when is this going to change? And you're hoping that someday this is going to change. And you see, that's where most people, most humans make a mistake and they lose out. Imagine that you're at the bottom of a mountain, you know, looking at a tall mountain and wanting and going to hike the mountain. There's one person who's thinking, when am I going to reach the top? And there's another person saying, I want to hike and reach the top. Do you notice the difference between these two statements? It's a totally different attitude. The saying that when will this happen is a lot more passive, and saying that I want to do it is a lot more active. You can feel the rush, the enthusiasm, the energy in it. And that is what life is asking of you. That is what life is asking of most of us. The difference is between you waiting for life to happen and life waiting for you. You see, when we wait for life to happen, we are allowing life to pour in all of these circumstances in front of us and saying, hey, walk us through that. You know, you can throw anything that you want to throw in the way, and I'm just a passive receiver, right? And when life is waiting for me, I get to decide how I want to carve out that path that's in front of me. Now, I don't get to choose everything. Like, I don't get to choose what kind of body I get or what family I get. But just like I get to choose what kind of clothes I want to wear, what kind of makeup I want to do, or jewelry and assets I want to wear, I get to decide what kind of attitude do I want to wear towards my life, what kind of makeup in my mind do I want to create towards whatever the circumstances are in front of me. And when we start making that change from being passive to extremely active, very enthusiastic about no matter what's in the way, I am going to get this done, that's when everything changes. There are two things that all of us require, all of you will require, if you want to get the success in life that you're thinking or you're wondering how other people have. Why is it easy for other people? Why is it so easy for somebody to hike up to the top? Why are some people just luckier than you are? Well, what you did not know about them is how did they hike up that journey? You don't know how they made it to the top. But here's what you get to decide. You get to say that I am going to choose from whatever I have in front of me. It's the two things are, one is your attitude towards it, and the second is the ability to take a risk. You see, there's nothing in life that you are going to be able to achieve with success and satisfaction unless you're ready to make a jump in uncertainty and say, I am willing to take the consequence, and I'm willing to allow it to be a mystery. Well, I have made this choice when I have taken the risk. Without taking a risk, you're not going to move forward in your life. You're not going to get those massive leaps of growth that you are wondering how other successful people have gotten in their lives. They really have had these two things with them. The attitude, the ability to take a risk. So it's like saying that, let's say that the weather outside your house, you know, if you're in Canada in the winter, it's like minus 30 degrees in New York or Canada. Or if you're in Arizona like I am in the summer, it's 42, 43, 44 degrees. It's like saying that when you say that, when will this change? Or I hope things will change. And we keep pushing against that wall with agitation and anger. And because I have three children and because I have so many responsibilities and because there's somebody with a terminal illness and we have this whole list of, because my life is so horrible and there are so many things happening in my life, I cannot change my life. My life is going to be horrible. It's like saying you're standing out in the heat and allowing yourself to be roasted until the weather changes 3 months later, until fall kicks in. It's like saying, I'm gonna stand in the heat and I'm gonna allow life to happen, the weather to happen, and I'm going to wait for that weather to change. That is the difference between people that are highly successful. They're not gonna wait there in the heat or in the cold and allow themselves to get a frostbite or to be roasted. They are going to find solutions, just like we do as humans, for other things in our life. We get into the air conditioner, we get jackets, we get things to wear. We find coping strategies. And just like that, there are special skills, tactics, methods, coping strategies that you can gain to be able to overcome that being roasted in the heat or feeling helpless and feeling like life is happening to you and deciding what happens to you and start taking charge and you start deciding what life happens in your life. And let me tell you that when I was a teenager and even in my early 20s, I was a highly depressed individual, even with significant suicidal behaviors. I have attempted suicide a couple of times. And at that time, my rigid belief was that this is my life, that other people, the adults around me, are going to abuse me. They're not going to understand me. And I had a whole list of because I don't have a mother, because nobody understands me, because of this, because of that. And I had convinced myself to believe that my life was going to be that box with those strict, very, very firm walls that are never going to fall or change. And I kept hoping that one day my life will change. And in that hope, I lost so many years. I lost so much because I could have changed a ton of things in that wait time. And after a decade, you know, as I started doing psychology and working on myself within a decade's time, as I started making that huge shift of breaking those walls, allowing those walls to fall and those boundaries to widen and say, hey, within the circumstances of my life, with the difficult people that I have, with the difficult circumstances, with the less money that I have, with the kind of body I have, what can I do? What is my power there? How can I recreate my life? And I use those coping strategies that I teach to my clients today in life coaching, through meditation, through life coaching strategies, through counseling, through thinking through, giving them potent, important introspective questions and questioning them, confronting them and asking them, you know, challenging them to look through their attitudes and fears and what are all those walls that they have, my clients have created. And as they start pushing those walls and changing that, you know, even from the wall, it starts becoming a sheet, you know, a sheet of feathers, and all the blessings start to pour in because now you are creating your life. It's like saying, you know how just like we have a body that has been given to us, life, God, or whatever you believe in, has given you a life. There are things that you can choose and there are things you cannot choose. Well, things you cannot choose, there's no point of pushing that, and there's no point in saying, hoping that one day it's going to choose. Then that's like saying, when my children grow up, I'll get to live my life. When my husband or, you know, my family member's terminal illness is over, I'll get to live my life. When I save more money, I'll get to look, you know, travel around the world. That's a very passive approach to life, and that's definitely not what successful people have ever done. Ask any successful person. And by success, I don't necessarily mean fame and money. I mean a person who feels very, very fulfilled and satisfied with life. They are the people who have lived every moment of their life, carving out like a sculptor carves out. Imagine if you had a horrible painting in front of you, like it looked really bad. Are you going to say, and if you were a painter, an artist, would you be willing to say, oh, that's a horrible painting and that's how it's going to be? Or would you be willing to take another sheet of paper and start carving out something beautiful? That's exactly what you get to do with life. And every minute of life that you are sticking around with the attitude of, this is horrible, my life is horrible because of the whole list of because that you have, and the beliefs that my job is going to be, I am only going to earn this much, or because I have so many children, I am not going to be able to. As long as you keep doing that to yourself, you're losing every moment of life that you can change to completely transform who you are. So today I am, if you were to see me, and those of you who know me since so many years ago could never ever believe that this could be Rima Desai standing in front of a camera, motivating, inspiring other people, training people from across the world, writing powerful articles, life coaching other women. Nobody could ever believe that, because I was one pot of shit, to be honest. I was one pot of depressed individual who with very fixed and rigid beliefs about what my life was going to be, hoping passively that some magic will happen. And there's only one person who can do magic in your life, and that's you. Well, if you believe in that power and if you trust how powerful you can be for yourself, it's time to start bringing that power into life. I hope you all get inspired through that and start looking into some wonderful changes that you can make with your attitude and by taking some risks and allowing uncertainty to flow into your life as you start carving out. You know, when a sculptor or when a painter is painting, they don't know exactly what that's going to look like. They have an image in mind, but it could come out very different from what they imagined, but it's nevertheless beautiful. You know why? Because it was their own creation. You want your life to be your own creation, not somebody else's. Bye-bye.